In this video, we're continuing on with the dividing square roots worksheet on the KutaSoftware website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free geometry worksheet. So our directions were to simplify. In number 13, we have the square root of 25 divided by the square root of 15. Right away, you could see that 25 is a perfect square and write this as 5 over the square root of 15. However, since our directions are to simplify, when we simplify, we do not want a square root in the denominator. And the easiest way to prevent that is to have a perfect square in the denominator. And I'm going to take you through the steps of how to do that, but I'll tell you right away, we're going to be multiplying by 1 a lot. Now remember, when we're multiplying by 1, it doesn't change the value of any of the numbers. However, we're not just multiplying by the number 1. We'll be multiplying by some numerator over the same denominator. So 3 over 3, that's 1. 4 over 4, that's also 1. Let's go ahead and work through 13, and you'll be able to catch on to what I mean. In number 13, we have the square root of 25 divided by the square root of 15. I'm going to combine those within the same square root to be the square root of 25 over 15. I can simplify 25 over 15, since both are divisible by 5, into 5 over 3, since 5 times 5 is 25, and 5 times 3 is 15. The square root of 25 over 15 is equivalent to the square root of 5 over 3. Now remember, I said the trick to simplifying and not having a square root on the bottom is to have the denominator within the square root be a perfect square. So we somehow want this 3 to be a perfect square. And in order to do that, we're going to multiply 5 over 3 by 1. And that 1 is going to be 3 over 3. So I'm not changing the value. This is still equal to the square root of 25 over the square root of 15. I'm just manipulating it by multiplying by 1. So now we'll have the square root of 5 times 3, which is 15, over 3 times 3, which is 9. That way, when I split up this fraction within the square root, I'll get the square root of 15 over the square root of 9, which the square root of 15 is simplified, and the square root of 9 we can write as 3, since 3 squared is equal to 9, the square root of 3 squared is 3. So our solution in number 13 is the square root of 15 over 3. I know this is probably a bit confusing right now, since we're manipulating the numbers into something that we want, but let's continue on to number 14, where we will be multiplying by 1 again. In number 14, we have the square root of 5 over the square root of 15. We can write this as the square root of 5 over 15, where the square root of 5 over 15 can be written as the square root of 1 over 3, since 1 times 5 is 5, and 3 times 5 is 15. Now remember, we want this denominator to be a perfect square. So again, we're going to multiply by 1, and in this case, it's going to be 3 over 3, since 3 times 3 will give us that perfect square. So we'll have the square root of 1 times 3, which is 3, over 3 times 3, which is 9. The square root of 5 over the square root of 15 is equivalent to the square root of 3 over 9. Now, splitting that up, we'll get the square root of 3 over the square root of 9, which equals the square root of 3 over 3. And that's the solution in number 14. In number 15, the square root of 10 over the square root of 6 is equivalent to the square root of 10 sixths. Both 10 and 6 are divisible by 2, so I'll have the square root of 5 thirds. Again, we want this denominator to be a perfect square. In order to do that, we're going to multiply it by itself, but in order to not change this value, we need to multiply by 1, so we're going to multiply by 3 over 3. Simplifying this, we'll get the square root of 5 times 3, which is 15, over 3 times 3, 9. The square root of 15 ninths, we can write as the square root of 15 over the square root of 9, which simplified is the square root of 15 divided by 3. Moving on to number 16, we'll have the square root of 15 divided by 6. Both are divisible by 3, so the square root of 15 sixths is the same as the square root of 5 halves, since 3 times 5 is 15 and 3 times 2 is 6. We want this denominator to be a perfect square. So far, the one we have been multiplying by is 3 over 3. However, in order to get 2 to be a perfect square, we're going to multiply 5 halves by 2 over 2, or 2 halves. 2 over 2 is equal to 1, so we're not changing the actual value of the original problem. We're just manipulating the numbers so that we can simplify. The square root of 5 halves times 2 halves is going to be the square root of 10 fourths. That's going to be equal to the square root of 10 over the square root of 4, which equals the square root of 10 over 2. Since 2 squared is equal to 4, and the square root of 4 is 2. In number 17, the square root of 8 over square root of 6, we can write as the square root of 8 divided by 6. Both of those can be simplified since they're even numbers, so we'll have the square root of 8 sixths as the square root of 4 thirds. The one that we're going to multiply by is going to be 3 over 3, and we're multiplying that within the square root. That is important to note. So the square root of 4 thirds times 3 thirds is the square root of 4 times 3 over 3 times 3, which is the square root of 12 ninths. We'll have the square root of 12 over the square root of 9, which equals the square root of 12 can be simplified down into the square root 2 squared times 3, since 4 times 3 is 12, and the square root of 9 is 3. So the square root of 2 squared times 3 divided by 3 is equal to 2 times the square root of 3 all over 3. In number 18, we have the square root of 6 divided by 15. That can be simplified to the square root of 2 fifths, since 2 times 3 is 6, and 5 times 3 is 15. 6 fifteenths is equal to 2 fifths. I want this denominator to be a perfect square, so I'm going to multiply by 1. The one that I'm multiplying by is 5 over 5, remembering that I'm multiplying within that square root. So now I'll have the square root of 2 times 5 over 5 times 5, which is 10 over 25. So I'll have the square root of 10 25ths. That's going to be equal to the square root of 10 over the square root of 25, which is the square root of 10 all over 5, since 5 squared equals 25, and the square root of 5 squared is 5. Square root of 10 over 5 is my solution in number 18. In number 19, I'm going to rewrite this as 3 times the square root of 3 over 5. I cannot simplify the fraction 3 fifths, so I'm going to make this 5, which is in the denominator, into a perfect square. I can do that by multiplying by 1, and the 1 I'm multiplying by is 5 fifths. And remember, I'm multiplying that within the square root. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 3 fifths times 5 fifths, which will give me 15 25ths. Breaking that up, I'll get 3 times the square root of 15 all over the square root of 25. That's equal to 3 times the square root of 15 all over 5. If you're confused at why this 3 is a numerator, then you can think of this positive 3 as 3 over 1. So that 3 will remain in the numerator. I'm going to rewrite number 20 as 3 fifths times the square root of 3 over 2. I need this denominator within the square root to be a perfect square. I'm going to do that by multiplying by 1, and the one I'm multiplying by is 2 over 2, and that's within the square root. So I'll have 3 fifths times the square root of 6 over 4, since 3 times 2 is 6 and 2 times 2 is 4. Breaking that up, I'll get 3 divided by 5 times the square root of 6 divided by the square root of 4. That's going to be 3 times the square root of 6 divided by 5 times the square root of 4, which is 2. 3 times the square root of 6 all over, or divided by 5 times 2, which is 10. This cannot be simplified any further, so 3 times the square root of 6 divided by 10 is my solution in number 20. In number 21, I need to somehow get this square root of 5 out of the denominator. In order to do that, I need to make it a perfect square. However, when we multiply by 1, we did that within a square root, and there's no square root currently within our numerator. If you remember, the square root of 1 is equal to 1. So if we were to multiply 4 by the square root of 1, that would not change the value of this number. So I'll rewrite this now as 4 thirds times the square root of 1 over 5. That way, now I can multiply by 5 over 5 within the square root in order to get my perfect square within the denominator, which is 5 squared. So now I'll have 4 thirds times the square root of 5 over 25. That will be 4 thirds times the square root of 5 over the square root of 25. 4 thirds times the square root of 5 over the square root of 25 is 4 times the square root of 5 all over 3 times the square root of 25, which is 5. So I'll have 4 times the square root of 5 all over 15 as my solution for number 21, since this cannot be simplified any further. In number 22, you can recognize right away that 2 divided by 2 is 1, so I'm left with the square root of 2 over the square root of 3. I'll rewrite that as the square root of 2 over 3, and I need to multiply by 1, and that 1 will be 3 thirds. So now I'll have the square root of 6 over 9, which can be broken up into the square root of 6 over the square root of 9, which is equivalent to the square root of 6 over 3. In number 23, I'll rewrite this as 5 times the square root of 4 fifths. I need to multiply by 1, and the 1 that I'm going to multiply by is 5 fifths within that square root in order to get a perfect square in the denominator. So I have 5 times the square root of 4 times 5, which is 20, over 5 times 5, which is our perfect square of 25. Splitting up that square root, I'll get 5 times the square root of 20 all over the square root of 25. That's equal to 5 times the square root of 20 all over the square root of 25 is 5. Notice now that 5 divided by 5 equals 1, so I'm left with the square root of 20. However, I know that there's a perfect square that can go into 20, so the square root of 20 can be simplified. The square root of 20 equals the square root of 2 squared times 5, since 4 times 5 equals 20, so number 23 equals 2 times the square root of 5. In number 23, there's another way to start the problem. You could recognize that 4 is a perfect square and start with 5 times 2 over the square root of 5. Eventually, you'll wind up with 2 times the square root of 5. So go ahead and try to do this problem starting at 5 times 2 over the square root of 5. Show your work in the comments below, or tell me which way you thought was easier. For now, let's move on to number 24. I'm going to write this as 3 over 2 times the square root of 5 over 2. I need to multiply this by 1 in order to turn the 2 into a perfect square. That 1 is going to be 2 over 2. So I'll have 3 halves times the square root of 10 over 4. Breaking up that square root, I'll have 3 over 2 times the square root of 10 over the square root of 4. So I'll have 3 times the square root of 10 over 2 times the square root of 4, which is 2. Working out that math, I'll get 3 times the square root of 10 over 2 times 2, which is 4. 3 times the square root of 10 divided by 4 is my solution in number 24. As always, like this video if you found it helpful and subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to comment below if you attempted to do number 23 at the starting point that I showed you. If you want to, go ahead and comment out your work so that other viewers will be able to see exactly what you did step by step.